Hello, Bobby Torres of Frightbox, recording here, critiquing subscriber mixes, episode 33. So without any further ado, let's jump into this group of mixes submitted by my loyal email subscribers. And our first mix here comes from Mr. Sebastian. Let's check it out. Okay, so far the mix itself is actually pretty solid and great vocal production and great vocal performance. Great guitar tones, again, across all of the instruments. Let's keep listening though. Okay, well, Sebastian, I have to say, overall, man, the mix is actually really solid. I don't think that's your issue. The main issue I'm hearing is that the drums sound very mechanical and they are lacking dynamics. They sound like programmed drums, if they are not programmed drums, which I'm pretty sure they are, but whether they're programmed drums or live drums with samples, you have to use automation and or adjust your MIDI velocities to create a natural sounding drum performance. Everything is so in balance, it's well written, but the drums just sound obviously fake. And we don't want that, unless that's what you're going for. So this right here is a prime example of a mix that sounds great, but the production is lacking slightly. So Sebastian, my main note here is to pay closer attention to the dynamics in your drum tracks and impart some more humanism into the actual drum tracks themselves before you even think about mixing. Okay, our next track here comes from James. Okay, I hear some digital clipping, and it looks like you have your mix completely pegged out. You don't have to have your mix pegged out. Don't worry so much about your master being screaming loud. It's unnecessary. Let's keep listening. Okay, so check this out. I'm playing the mix and the drums didn't even kick in yet, and you could see it's completely pegged and hanging out by zero, which means the mix is lacking dynamics. And again, I hear actual clipping. Okay, overall, the music sounds cool, but again, we have some really obviously programmed sounding drums. I would say spend a little more time programming your drums and adding dynamics and subtle variation to the cymbal hits and the snare hits to make the drums sound like an actual human is playing them. And do not squash your mix like this. Again, I hear tons of clipping and it's distracting me from paying attention to the song. So James, it sounds like you have a lot of talent. Your mix is pretty solid, but I think you're a little too worried about making your mix loud. And I'd recommend focusing a lot of your attention on the programming of the drums themselves to make them sound more like an actual drummer. Thank you for your submission. All right, our next mix here comes from my man Kenny. I'm getting some old school nu metal vibes here. Okay, the instrumentation sounds pretty solid, but the vocals sound overly dynamic and they sound like they need more compression. Yeah, overall, the mix itself actually has a cool retro sort of dark, raw, nu metal vibe, which I actually like. It reminds me a lot of the old Ross Robinson stuff. But the vocals are just too dynamic and they could use a lot more compression. Who cares if you're compressing your vocals 24 dB? For this style of music, they have to compete with the guitar tracks. It's funny, people will overcompress their master bus, but they won't compress their vocal tracks. It should be the opposite, in my opinion. So Kenny, thanks so much for your submission. Compress those vocals and get back to me. Okay, our final mix here comes from Sean. A Again, we have some overly fake sounding drum tracks. Guys, think in your mind what a drummer sounds like in a room. No drummer hits their snare with 100% velocity on every single snare hit. That's not how human beings play. Now, again, this is all subjective. Maybe you want your drums to sound fake, but if you're going for a record that sounds like actual human beings are playing on it, make sure you pay close attention to your drum dynamics. Right off the bat there, I hear a lot of ghost notes on the snare that are the exact same velocity as the main snare hits. Again, the mix itself actually isn't bad. I just hear some crudely programmed drum tracks. And again, a mix that's so clipped that it's actually distracting to listen to and things are stepping on each other's toes. Now, the true secret to achieving a louder master that sounds very pleasing is to deal with your drum dynamics via clipping, maybe a little bit of saturation on the drum bus or the snare drum, and to stack processors on your master bus that are each doing very little within themselves. You cannot achieve a screaming loud master with one plugin. If you try to do this, you will end up with a master that sounds like this, something that's very harsh to listen to, where everything just sounds like it's stepping on top of one another. Okay, another problem with this mix is that some of the instrumentation is out of time, and the vocalist is sort of ebbing and flowing in a not musical way. Again, the song sounds cool, he's got a great voice, guitar tone sounds cool, but things are not pocketed. Yeah, this is all over the place, especially timing-wise. Again, the actual sounds themselves are not the problem, and that is the theme I found with this group of mixes. So many of us are obsessed with mixing that we forget about the actual performance and the production itself. And I have news for you. If you start out with weak-sounding source tracks that were not well-produced, you are not going to have a polished pro-level mix. That's sort of the secret that no one really mentions on YouTube or on the internet in general. Now, the good news is you do not need better equipment, you don't need a fancy room, you don't need to change anything outside of your approach. You just need to approach your productions like a pro producer would in the real world. Now, to help you out with this, I have something called my polished production checklist. It is a simple, straightforward PDF that outlines my approach to producing pro-level results, regardless of gear, so that you could focus on the things that matter, which in turn will allow you to craft a pro-level mix. Again, using the exact same tools and plugins and gear that you're currently using. The polished production checklist is absolutely free right now, and you can download it right now by clicking the link below in this video's description. So I would just like to shout out and thank everyone for submitting this excellent group of mixes. Again, the mixes themselves were actually pretty good. They just needed work in the production department. And I'm finding this to be a very common thing amongst the mixes that are sent to me. Now, on this topic, if you are interested in submitting your song for me to review on this channel, there are detailed instructions in this video's description. And also, if you would like to watch me produce a song from scratch using low budget gear, recorded entirely within non-studio spaces, there is a link to that video above in the cards. If you're someone at home who produces their own music, you're not gonna wanna miss this video. Until next time, drink that spindrift.